Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seale, the High Level Queen, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a Facebook comment reply auto bot, or you might know it as a Facebook comment auto reply, and we're going to do this without Manychat in just 4 easy steps. So let's get started. All right, step 1, what you want to do is sign up for a free trial of GoHighLevel, which is an all-in-one CRM platform that I use to send two-way SMS, email, to integrate Facebook, Instagram, messengers, do auto comment replies, AI, social media posting, and more. So after you have that done, what we're going to do first is we're going to go into settings, and then we're going to hit up integrations, and we're going to make sure that we integrate our Facebook connection. Here you're going to see if it's connected or not. If it's not, go ahead and click on connect and choose the Facebook pages that you want to integrate. I always highly recommend selecting all, that way you don't run into problems down the road. Step 2, what we're going to do is we're going to click on marketing workflows, and we're going to create a new workflow. Now we're going to go ahead and click on create recipe because I can actually help you do this really, really quickly. So we're going to choose the Facebook comment automation recipe, and this is actually going to do all the hard work for us. So here you have your trigger, which is Facebook comments on a post. So step 3, we're going to set up our trigger and our filters. Here, you're just going to select the Facebook page that you want to use, and then here is the phrase that you want to use with this. So this just means that, let's say in your Facebook post you have, do you want my free guide? Type guide down below, right? So this is if they type guide, or do you want my free checklist? Type checklist down below. So here I'm just going to have contains phrase checklist, and then post type. Here is your, where you're going to choose your custom or your published post. So you can actually choose a, you can do this for every different post that you want, or every single post. It just depends on what you want to do here. So if you want to choose a specific post or all posts, if you want to choose all posts, you can just delete this. If you want to add a certain post, do that. Now, I will say if you do it this way, you are going to have to create a new trigger every time you do a comment stack. And then track first level comments only. Okay, so if you turn this off, it's actually going to become quite chaotic, because what it's going to do is it's going to trigger on every single comment, even if someone replies underneath someone else's. So I think I would leave that on for now. Go ahead and save this trigger. And so we have our trigger of what's going to fire. Now we need to create our actions on what is actually going to happen after we have the trigger. So step 4, we are going to create our actions. So the first one here that the recipe gave us is respond on comment. This is actually really cool, because whenever someone says checklist, the bot is going to automatically reply underneath and say, hey, check your DM. Thanks for showing interest. Please check your DM. Now, this is really important, because if you have the same thing every single time, you have a higher likelihood of getting put in Facebook jail. So I would definitely add several more in here, and so on. And then you can also make this automatically like the comments. Go ahead and click on save. Now we've told them that we sent them a message, but now we have to actually send them the message, right? So the next one is reply to comment via DM. So we're gonna just type our message in here. Hi, I'm excited you want to start your personal finance journey. That was already in there. You can actually add a contact name in here, first name, if you want to. This is actually gonna pull through the information from Facebook. So if you want to make it a little bit more personalized, go ahead and add that in there. And then down here at the bottom, these are gonna be like the action buttons. So if you don't even want these, you can just delete them like that. if you want them, just keep them there. And then here you have the wait step. I'm gonna go ahead and click save, and now you can see that it actually deleted those annoying little buttons that we had previously. Then what we're gonna do is save it, and now we can test it. Okay, so after we turn it on, we have to click on publish and then save. We can go ahead and test it. Now here you notice when I set up my trigger, I actually created it only to reply on a published post. So what I would have to do, I can click on view on Facebook, and if I go ahead and type checklist like that, I should get a reply and a DM saying, hey, here's your DM. Hey, here's your checklist. Now, if it doesn't work, you could have some hidden Manychat integrations that you need to go remove. But look at this. It looks like it actually does work. How about that? So let's see if it actually did the comment as well. Hey, I sent you a DM. So look, I sent myself a DM. That's beautiful. You can see that it is working. I have worked with clients in the past who they were having trouble basically breaking their Manychat integration because Manychat tries to completely take over your Facebook page. So if that is the case, you have to actually untangle it, and I'm going to show you how to do that. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is open your Facebook page and then go ahead and switch to the account that manages your Facebook page. Okay, once this loads, we are going to go into settings. Make sure you're not in the business manager. Make sure that you're actually in the Facebook page settings. Okay, we're going to click on page setup, and then we're going to click on advanced messaging. And you should be able to see lead connector, and then you could have Manychat here. All right, so if you're having problems with lead connector working, you're actually going to want to turn off the permissions for Manychat here. But you can also set your primary receiver, and you'll see like mine says Manychat, but for some reason it's working. But you can actually set that to lead connector, and you can set both of them to lead connector here. And then if you want to remove Manychat, you can do that, but try to change your receiver. And if that doesn't work, you can actually just remove your Manychat permissions altogether. I hope this video helps you to set up a Facebook reply autobot. And don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me, and get a link to your free trial and bonuses in the description below. I'll see you next time.